Hello, my name is Payam Rezai. I'm a reader in the Faculty of Science, Technology, Engineering and Mathematics here at the Open University, and I am the program director for the MSc in Mental Health Science. I've been involved from the very beginning in designing the course, putting it together, and in producing the course as well. So I've had a central role in this program. I'm a neuroscientist with over 20 years of funded research experience into brain development, neurodegenerative diseases, and more recently into the neurobiology of autism. So my interest has been very much focused into the neurosciences and more recently into neuroscience and the mental health area, and I've been teaching quite broadly at postgraduate level for the past 15 years across a broad range of topics, from ethics to not just neuroscience and mental health, but ethics, postgraduate writing skills, copyright, intellectual property, and most recently induction courses on succeeding in postgraduate study. So it's a broad portfolio. And I've led symposia, national symposia, on topics related to mental health science, on psychosis, dementia, autism, and I'm planning to do so in the future too. Mental health conditions affect about one in four of us in any given year. And this particular course is understanding the biology and psychology that is related to mental health conditions as global priorities in the 21st century. So we're talking about stress, anxiety, depression, psychosis and dementia, and understanding the diagnosis, causes and treatments for these conditions is at the heart of what we are putting together as part of this course. We designed the course with anyone who has an academic or a professional interest in mental health sciences and understanding these conditions in mind. So if you are interested in understanding more about the diagnosis, causes and interventions, if you're already working in a professional or clinical setting, if you are a psychology student who wants to carry on and do a doctorate or a research career, pursue a research career, or indeed for anyone who wants to move on to either a leadership position or management or strategy position in a healthcare setting, then this will be the right course for you. Well, there are several things that are special about this Master's in Mental Health Science. One is that it capitalizes on 40 years of research and teaching experience in neuroscience and behavior. As an open university, we are the world leaders in distance online education for part-time students. And it means that you can do this course while working or fit it around your lifestyle. We use audiovisual material, including those from the BBC archives, that we are very privileged to be able to have access to. We also use first-hand accounts of individuals with these conditions. So we relate the conditions from a psychological and biological perspective to the real world and how it affects people's lives. We've pioneered a special online peer review activity and group work that you cannot find anywhere else, because this was developed here at the Open University. We have a long-standing legacy of having offered a similar course at the Open University on neural aging and addiction, which ran for 13 years. I chaired it in its final presentations. It was highly successful. It was initiated back in the late 90s, and Trevor Robbins, FRS, was associated with that particular course. This master's course is run over 3 years. It's in three stages, and it's part-time. So stage one looks at developing postgraduate skills and focuses on key topics. So these are stress, anxiety, and depression. In the second stage, you will get to learn more about these conditions in the context of psychosis and dementia. So it expands further your knowledge base and understanding of the diagnosis, causes, and interventions. In the final stage, you get to do a project. Now this is typically a research project based around a critical literature review, and it's on a topic that's related to your studies on the key topics in mental health science. Well, students would be able to go on to any number of academic, research or professional careers. Some may already be in professional careers, either in a care setting or in a clinical setting, and want to take this to inform their professional practice. Others may want to go on to research careers or doctorates, including clinical psychology, and others may be taking it because they're interested in knowing more about mental health sciences at a deeper level. So it is open to a lot of positions. People can go on to various other sectors, the private sector, the public sector, human resources, leadership positions, policy makers. So the possibilities are there for people to do with it as they will.